Hello, I'm Lori Steiner, sitting in for Armin Budish. Welcome to Golden Opportunities.
Today, is it time to get a move on? We'll unpack advice on tackling the transition to a retirement community. Then, we'll help you get a leg up on keeping your limbs looking and feeling lovely. Social Security makes a statement. We'll state how to get yours and what it means. Plus, have a heart. We'll find out how stepping out can help step up your heart health. And even after you retire, your pension's not as safe as you may think.
Time to get GO-ing, so pull up a chair and join us at our kitchen table for Golden Opportunities. You've made yourself at home, in your home, for perhaps 20, 30, or more years. But now, instead of feeling comfortable, you're feeling a bit concerned, whether it's the upkeep of the house, the issues of aging. You're starting to think about making a move, and you're considering a retirement community. But will the lifestyle be to your liking? David Schell says there are options for everyone. David is the executive director of Breckenridge Village in Willoughby. Good to see you again, Dave.
Nice being here, Lori. Thank you.
Okay, so why a continuing care community, like a retirement kind of community, rather than a small house or a condo?
Sure. I think the peace of mind that kind of comes knowing that there's available services on the campus, regardless of what the needs are. You mentioned 20, 30 years, and they can change. And then there's just a whole array of activities to stay active and independent. Those things just can't be found in a condominium.
Okay, so I know that some folks have the impression that you give up a lot to go into a retirement community. Is that really true?
Absolutely not. I think there's not only the tangibles that we talked about of really the continuum, but then there's the intangibles, the socialization, all of those things that come with it. Dr. Thomas, a specialist in our field of aging, talks about helplessness, loneliness, and boredom. I mean, things you absolutely want to avoid. There's no pill for it.
Mm-hmm.
And we really focus on the things to keep people active and engaged, and that's the number one goal.
Keeping active.
All right, absolutely.
So talking about lifestyle options, what kind of accommodations will somebody experience if they go into retirement community?
There's a lot of different options. And again, we talk about kind of three basic phases or needs, that time of independence, that time of transition, and then dependence. We really want to try to avoid that time of dependence and focus on independent. And so there's apartments, suites, condominium-styled homes, and we want to keep people as independent for as long as possible. Then there's those transition periods, fracture, knee replacement, something like that. You want high quality rehab to know that those services are available. A navigator, we're there to help there.
Better, right?
You want to get better. Back into independent mm-hmm. living. And then the last, unfortunately, if there's something like Alzheimer's, you want to know that there's a high quality nursing component available. But that's kind of the component we want to try to avoid, all of us do.
Yeah, yeah. You've had residents been there for many years now, right, and have experienced this transition?
I in August started my 28th year at Breckenridge.
Oh,
I've known
goodness.
Residents that have lived there that entire time period and span the generations, like you say, from 55 to well over 100. And so you're trying to look at needs over a very broad, long period of time.
Sure, yeah. Is there some way people can get a chance to see these various options you've talked about?
Yeah, absolutely. We want people to really kind of come and kick the tires and, more importantly, talk to the residents. So on September 20th and 21st, we've got an open house at the Reserve of Grace Woods. We also have a great program, a pay to move. We're doing a special before snow flies, heaven forbid. And so we've got a program to help individuals to move into the one-bedroom apartments at Breckenridge Village North. And then we do a special for the boomers, 55 to 70, and we've got some things to help them think about it too.
Okay, now if I want to move in, I got 40 years worth of stuff in my attic. Help for that too?
Yeah, we've got a couple of seminars that are coming up. We've got one on September 16th. We're sponsoring a free rate sizing seminar that's open to everyone, and that's a hard transition.
Mm-hmm.
And then on the 23rd, we're also presenting an A to Z of home sales, and would encourage everyone to come to that.
All right, sounds really good. Feeling at home, enjoying activities, hobnobbing with the neighbors, and having care options on site. Now that's a great way to live. To find out more, attend the open house and seminars at Breckenridge Village or give them a call. The number's coming up next.
Find out more by calling Breckenridge Village at 440-954-8359 or click to www.breckenridgeohio.org. Next, keeping your legs in circulation. But first, Leonardo da Vinci, Winston Churchill, Albert Einstein, Thomas Edison, and General George Patton each excelled in differing areas: art, politics, science, and the military. Yet historians have concluded that they all faced the same challenge. So, what factor may have interfered with their education? We'll spell out the answer when we return.
My husband and I got into the car and we couldn't do it. We couldn't pick one baby over the other. Coming to Metro changed the entire pregnancy. We actually started to become happy with our situation. We owe a big thank you to Metro. I can't imagine our family without Sam.
It's been determined that dyslexia was the diagnosis for Leonardo da Vinci, Winston Churchill, Albert Einstein, Thomas Edison, and General George Patton. Brilliant minds that overcame a significant educational challenge.
You're having trouble getting around. Walking is a big pain. So you find yourself just kind of hanging around your pad. Well, pad could be the reason your home is becoming your haven. PAD is really P-A-D and stands for peripheral arterial disease. Dr. Murray Moyes is an attending surgeon at MetroHealth, and she's here to spell out the signs and symptoms of this really serious condition. Happy to have you here. Now, we talked about the acronym, but what does that really mean, the PAD?
So peripheral arterial disease is from atherosclerosis, which is commonly known as hardening of the arteries. And as you age, as well as some other risk factors, smoking, high blood pressure, high cholesterol, they can all contribute to hardening of the arteries, which can lead to narrowing, and in worst cases, lead to blockages.
Okay. Is this heart-related, or is this other places in your body?
Well, atherosclerosis can affect any blood vessel in your body, most commonly is the heart. Mm-hmm. But the second most common place is the legs, and okay. It starts off with pain with walking.
All right. Yeah. So in your legs. So. You mentioned briefly some of the risk factors. Can you go a little bit more in depth on some of those risk factors for us?
Well, smoking is number one.
Oh boy.
You often hear about smoking and its effects on the lungs, but smoking is actually toxic to the blood vessels. And over time, 20, 30 years of smoking can lead to plaques that can lead to blockages.
So it's not necessarily cholesterol. I'm sure that has a factor too, but so I think we have up on the screen too. Cholesterol, as I just mentioned, smoking, like you mentioned. So how about these other things?
Well, aging, you know, we're all aging. That's not a risk factor that you can modify, but you're...
yeah.
what we wish. But diet, high cholesterol, is a very important risk factor that can be managed, as well as stopping smoking.
Okay. So it's like everything in health, right? Exercise, eating right, taking care of yourself. So whether we have the risk factors or not, what are the symptoms of the condition so we can kind of recognize if it's happening?
So the symptoms generally start with pain with walking, and the kind of pain that you have, it doesn't start right away. As you're walking, as you're moving, as your muscles are working, they're asking for more blood, more oxygen from your heart. Your heart tries to provide that, but the blood is trying to squeeze past all those narrowing and blockages. It doesn't get there in time, and you get pain, just like a muscle cramp, usually in the calves.
Okay.
People stop and rest for 2 to 3 minutes, the pain goes away. And then, once you start again, the same distance, sometimes a little bit further, once again, the cramping, usually in the calves, sometimes in the thighs.
Okay, but it's not actually a cramp because it goes away, right?
Right, well, it is a cramp because the muscles, they build up a lactic acid, just like when you do heavy exercise.
So it really is a cramp, but it relaxes itself faster than a regular cramp would? Or?
Right, because you're at rest, your muscles don't need as much blood, so it dissipates over time, but then, once again, once you start walking, the same pain.
Wow, sounds like it could really harm your legs too. Now, I know if we feel a pain now and then, Don't just put it off to old age, which I bet a lot of people do. It sounds like you really need to see your doctor for something like this.
Right. If it's regular and recurrent, then you need to see your physician, because then you can talk about some of the risk factors that you can modify to improve your walking distance, but also improve your heart health as
well. What if you've already got it? Is there any treatments?
There are some medications that can be used. Occasionally, it can come to either angioplasty and stenting or surgery.
Okay, so it's something we can do, but we'd rather not get it in the first place, right?
Right, exactly.
Okay.
So
always...
if you increase your physical activity, eat right,
stop smoking
if you're a smoker.
Good information. Leg pain when you walk is worrisome. Don't just try to walk it off. See your physician to see if it's peripheral arterial disease. That's a step towards healing. My thanks to Dr. Moyes for joining us today.
Thank you.
To learn more, call Metro Health at 216-778-7800 or visit www.metrohealth.org. Next, understanding your Social Security statement. Looking for places to go, things to do? Welcome to our community calendar. Learn how to avoid costly Medicaid mistakes at 4 free seminars presented by the law offices of Budish, Solomon, Steiner, and Peck. Monday, September 15th at 2 p.m., the event will take place at the law offices in Beechwood. And then again that evening at 7 p.m. at the Holiday Inn Cleveland South in Independence. Wednesday, September 17th at 7 p.m., the seminar will take place at the Westlake Recreation Center. And then on Thursday, September 18th at 2 p.m., at the Middleburg Heights Community Center. For more information or to reserve your seat, call 1-888-236-5173 or click to www.butishandsolomon.com.
Do you know how much you've paid into Social Security? What about how much you'll get out of it? That information and more is on your Social Security statement. Haven't seen one in your mailbox for a while? There's a reason for that, and Jim Lineweaver is here to tell us what it is, as well as to relate the rules on how to read it. Jim is a certified financial planner with the Lineweaver Financial Group. Good to see you again there.
Yeah, good to see you.
So, I mean, this Social Security statement is really important in planning your retirement, you know, right? We used to get them all the time. What happened?
Yeah, well, Social Security decided to go green, and
Ooh.
They tried to do everything online, but unfortunately it wasn't as successful as they wanted it to be. So up until 2011, what happened was the people between age 25 and 60, you'd every year get a statement,
mm-hmm.
which is probably a little overkill.
Yeah, especially so when you're younger, going, who cares?
Exactly. Yeah, I'm worried about the food on the table or
yeah.
where I'm going this weekend. So in any event, what ended up happening is after 2011, they said that you're going to have to start getting online to get any information unless you're over age 60. They were still going to send it to you at that point.
Mm-hmm.
They found out that only 10 million people got online to get their records. That's only 6% of the population. And then they're getting inundated with phone calls,
mm-hmm.
and they're trying to instruct people online, and it takes some steps to get going. So it didn't work out as well as planned.
Mm-hmm.
So what they're going to do now, starting this month, is they're actually going to resend out statements to everybody, but it's not annually. It's going to be in 5-year bands. So
mm-hmm.
what'll happen is if you're 25, 30, 35, 40, 45, 50, they're going to automatically send that statement out to you and give you a lot of information that can be really helpful to help you plan for retirement.
What if you don't want to wait for your statement?
You can jump right online still and sign up. And
sign up
the
for
people
my
that have
account.
Already, people that are already signed up are not going to get it in
okay.
the mail. So if you can't sign up, just go to socialsecurity.gov/myaccount and get it set up. It's a much easier way to go.
Okay, so whether we've got the hard copy or whether we're looking online at our statement, what exactly is it going to tell us?
Yeah, well, it's going to give you a lot of really good information. What it's going to do, it's going to tell you how many credits you have. You need 40 credits to be eligible for Social Security. You can only get 4 credits in a year, so you really need 10 years of working to
mm-hmm.
get Social Security. If you retire early at 62, how much will you receive? The maximum deferral is till age 70, so how much would you receive if you delayed
mm-hmm.
it? And then also, what's your full Social Security retirement age? Most people, it's still 66, but if you were born after 1960, it's actually age 67.
Okay, and if you don't have enough credits and you stop working for a while, like you stay home with kids, Do you get more when you go back to work? It just adds on?
It does. It'll just pick up right where you left off, which is great.
Okay.
It also gives any spousal benefits in case you pass away. If you become disabled, that information's on there. Also, how much did you pay for Medicare and into Social Security program through the years as well. So it's very informative.
Okay, well, what if you're looking at your statement and it's based on your earnings, right? You think the earnings are wrong, therefore the payment would be wrong. Is there something you can do?
Yes, there is, and it's not going to be easy.
Oh, no.
But what you can do, and this is why you want to check it pretty regularly, because you don't want to go more than a couple years if they've misreported your gross earnings, so like things from a W-2 and things along that nature. So every 2, 3 years or 5 years, get in there, check it out. If it's wrong, then what happens is there's an 800 helpline that you can contact, and we have it for your viewers as well. That's 800-772-1213, Monday through Friday, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. What you might also find helpful is just go to the local office and have some documentation, whatever proof you have that you were paid
more. You got to take those W-2s or whatever.
Yeah, get that into the office and have them help you out.
And if they only send you your statement every 5 years, you better keep 5 years worth of records, or you better get on that My Account online and keep track of it more often.
Excellent, because it all comes into your factor of what you're ultimately going to receive. So you're not going to go back 20, 30 years and be able to catch something.
I had a client who did that once.
Really?
She had a shoebox full of everything, yeah. We want you to have a secure future. Your Social Security retirement statement gives you essential information you need for providing support to yourself and to your loved ones. To learn more, contact Social Security or give Jim a call. The number's coming up next.
For more information, call the Lineweaver Financial Group at 1-888-313-4009 or click to www.lineweaver.net. Next, helping the beat go on. It's time to get up and go, an exercise minute on golden opportunities.
Hey everybody, it's Mike Carbon from Breakout Fitness, and we're here today to show you how to do a donkey kick. This is an excellent exercise. It's not only going to work and strengthen that lower back area, but also it's going to build the glutes. You ready?
I need this.
Let's do it. All right. We're going to start on all fours. Here in the studio, we have our exercise mats. You at home, go ahead and grab a spot on the floor. We want our hands to be shoulder width apart. Our knees should be about the same. What we're looking for here is we're going to bring our knees straight in, and then we're going to try to keep a 90 degree bend as we bring it straight up and out. Perfect, okay? So we're going to bring it in and then up and out. We want 12 to 15 repetitions. Let's go ahead. We can switch and try the other side. In and out. All right, how you feeling, Lori?
Really good.
Looks good. All right, Lori's doing a slightly easier version of this.
I need a slightly easier version.
There you go. Those beginners at home, this is a way that you can build that muscle and still strengthen the same area, okay? 12 to 15, 2 to 3 times a week. And now it's your turn to get up and go.
For your copy of the exercise booklet, please send $1 for postage to Golden Opportunities, 23240 Chagrin Boulevard, Suite 450, Beechwood, Ohio, 44122.
Cardiovascular disease is the number one killer of Americans. Number one. So keeping our hearts healthy and healing hearts that need help is vitally important to ensuring our health. To aid in this effort, Medical Mutual of Ohio is a sponsor of the Cleveland Heart Walk, presented by the American Heart Association. But they don't stop there. Medical Mutual's Chief Financial Officer, Ray Mueller, is a co-chair of the event, and he's here to move us to get moving, right?
Yes.
All right, I know it's true, but it's shocking to me every time I hear that heart disease is the number one killer of people.
You know, it is shocking, Lori. Somebody in America dies every 39 seconds from heart disease.
Oh, yeah.
The other thing is infants. Heart disease, or I'm sorry, congenital heart defects is the number one killer of infants for those that have birth defects.
Wow.
And the other thing is, another fact I wanted to get out there was that women, there's more women that die from heart disease than from all forms of cancer every year. And you know, recently we had a friend that died from a heart attack, so it touches close to home.
Oh yeah, everybody, so. With that many people. So how does the walk help make everybody well?
So what we're trying to do is raise money for education and for research, and a lot of that research is critical, and it will be performed here in Cleveland. The other thing is the fundraising will go support our the Heart Association's 2020 impact goal.
Okay.
So what that is to try to improve Americans' cardiovascular health by 20% and to reduce heart and stroke related deaths by 20% by the year 2020.
All right. Okay, that sounds like a worthwhile goal, huh? Yeah. So how does the commitment to the Heart Walk fit into the commitment that Medical Mutual has to the community?
Sure, not just the community, but our employees too. So we start out, we have a pretty robust employee wellness program where we educate our employees. We encourage them to take health assessments, get their blood sugar levels and cholesterol levels, understand what they are and how to control them, make them better. We have a nice fitness center right on site, and we encourage healthy eating in our cafeteria. As far as the community goes, we're big supporters in the communities that we're in. Mm-hmm. So activities such as Harvest for Hunger, Habitat for Humanity. Mm-hmm. We sponsor the Outstanding Senior Volunteer Awards. We give scholarships to college students, and we also have a mutual appreciation program where we try to do business with our customers.
Okay.
In addition to that, the sponsoring of the Heart Walk is important. It's community-based. It helps our community have better lives, healthier lives. And so it's just a good way to support our communities.
It really does. It helps everybody out. So sure. I'm convinced. We're ready to walk.
Okay.
What do we have to do?
Okay, there's a few things you need to do. So the first is mark your calendar for September 27th. Secondly, check out the website that's on the screen. You can go there, find out a little bit about fundraising activities, how you can help, and some of the logistics about the Heart Walk.
Does it have to be a real long walk?
No, it can be 1 or 3 miles.
Okay.
And
I think most people probably handle a 1 mile walk, right?
Yeah. I can do that.
You can do that, right?
So
you're going to be there, right?
I will be there.
All right.
And hopefully everybody else will be there too.
So. All right. Great information.
Thank you.
The Cleveland Heart Walk is a step in the right direction towards better heart health for everyone. Follow Ray's advice and go online to get registered. My thanks to Ray for showing us how Medical Mutual not only talks the talk, but they walk the walk.
Thanks, Lauren.
Learn more about Medical Mutual of Ohio by visiting their website, www.medmutual.com/2014options, or call 1-866-488-3266. Next, how pension de-risking may harm your financial future.
Hilltop Village Apartments is retirement living at its best. Residents enjoy a wide variety of activities and living services with all large first floor apartments, private screened-in patios with beautiful park views, daily dining room meals, free laundry facilities, 24-hour staff, and so much more. Enjoy safe, comfortable independence at a very affordable price. Call today for a tour and learn how you can get your first month's rent free. Hilltop Village Apartments, retirement living at its best.
Did you miss a phone number or website? Then here's your second chance, because we're going to list all of that information again. Then we'll be back to tell you about some risky business pertaining to your pensions. Those monthly pension checks began arriving. And we bet those dollars have made a huge difference for your financial security. But recently, your former company contacted you with a surprising choice. Continue receiving your monthly checks from an insurance company, or take a lump sum. This pension fund practice is called de-risking and is becoming more and more common. But when your company de-risks, your risks can soar. More and more American companies are making moves to eliminate their pension obligations through this process. For example, General Motors did it. Verizon did it, Heinz did it, and that's just three major examples. There's many more. Typically, the company gives the retiree two options. First, the company could buy an annuity from an insurance company, and the retiree would then continue to receive the same monthly checks from the insurer like they have been up until that point. Or second, the company retires or offers the retiree a one-time lump sum payout. Okay, neither option is perfect. If you're considering the annuity, as long as the insurance company is really financially strong and remains in business, you should be fine with the monthly annuity payment. But if the insurance company fails, and that's not impossible, it happens quite frequently, or if that insurance company later sells off the annuity to another weaker insurance company, you could be in really big trouble. So, does this mean that you should take the lump sum? Well, not necessarily. If you are terminally ill and know that you don't have long to live, then maybe the lump sum is better. Or if you're great at managing money and investments, it might be a good choice. But if your investments don't do well or you spend the money, then your future finances could really be grim. Let's say you decide to go with the insurance company, thinking that the government will back up your money if the company fails. Well, think again. This is not like a pension guaranteed by the Federal Pension Benefit Corporation. Now, Ohio does have a guarantee association, but its coverage is limited. I don't suggest you go into the annuity thinking you're protected if the life insurance company goes under. We've been seeing a major change in pension programs. Fewer companies are even offering lifetime pension benefits. And now, even if you're already retired, the company may try to offload its obligations. If you get a notice from your former company or pension plan, please contact a lawyer or financial advisor to discuss your options. Your secure retirement may depend on it.
Call Budish, Solomon, Steiner, and Peck at 1-888-236-5173 for more information or to schedule a speaker for your organization, or log on to www.bssplaw.com.
Thanks for joining us. We're off next week, so be sure to join us September 21st, and remember at 12:30 if you missed this week's later time start, when we'll fill you in on how to be smart about your smile. We'll give advice on straightening your spine, and we'll give you much needed legal and other advice. But until then, please remember to make the most of your golden opportunities.
Would you like to join our kitchen conversation? All you have to do is call toll-free 1-877-765-1543 and leave us your question, name, and phone number. Or log on to www.golden.tv for all the latest information and show updates.